home for good indication and good points. And I'll be talking on two aspects. One is manual endothelial keratoplasty. Manual is both the sense like DSEC and DMEC. DMEC will be largely covered by Rajesh. I'll be talking only the dissection part. So basically I see like this, this is a crude product and this is the end product. You see that we IBank supplies tissue and there are people, they cut the tissue differently and there are P-cut tissue is also available. And we have a different group of surgeons who use these tissues differently and some are expensive. So why manual DMEC? You know that the cost is very big factor in our country. And if you see the Indian economic profile versus the cataract surgery, last year we did 6.5 million cataract surgery. And if you see the government and NGO, they actually covered 60% of the surgery. And if you see the PBK incidence, 0.2%, that leaves 13,000. Actually, every year we are producing, and among these 13,000, 7,000 people, they do not have money to go for this surgery. So there is manual DSEC. This is very beautiful instrument, no financial interest. I'm using for last 13 years. And it is very cozy instrument. You just take in your hand, and you see that dissection, it requires little practice, and one view is through the external camera and one through the microscope. And you see that we use just simple lamellar dissector, which we use in normal SICS. What I used to tell that if anybody can do SICS, you go little further to go for a manual dissection. So it is like that, only your centration and your holding of the that artificial anterior chamber in your left hand is very important, and that white arrow actually shows the horizontal line about the plane, and you rotate the hand when you reach the other end, like 6 o'clock from your side. So always try to stay parallel with the back surface and your dissection will be perfectly all right. And to my mind, automated dissection, which will be TTL, will be tamed. It is an open dissection, but manual dissection is always closed dissection through a 4.5 to 5 millimeter limbal incision, and it is back surface parallel. So manual dissection is good. I am using for last 12-13 years. Lot of surgeries has been done and result is persistently doing good. And the manual dissection, the donor, ultimately the donor damage is not there when you learn the technique. And only thing that you have to choose the right blades for the first peripheral cut, because nowadays we are using two different or three different media, like one is MK medium, that is 50%, and one is like Optisol or Cornisol nowadays from Modolab, where the corneal thickness is much less, about 50 micron less. So your peripheral cuts will be 50 micron less when you use a Cornisol or Optisol GS piece of tissues. And if you see, the preferable thickness is 120 to 150 micron, and graft thickness automated versus manual, it is similar. But if you see the peripheral edge, where the automated it is little thicker, but manual, as we start always at the limbus, so our central part is always uniform thickness. And you see that ultra thin people are doing double manual dissection to raise this ultra thin lenticule. And with manual dissect, you can always achieve when you are, you don't need, initially you need pachymeter to check the, but later on you can always change it. So the outcome, manual automated is almost similar, donor dislocation is similar, donor damage is similar, like buttonholing, DM perforation, all happens in both the things. But the main problem with automated one, that the machine might betray with it. And last year we had a similar two machines were there for DSEC workshop, and both the machines were not working. There are three trainees, 16 surgeries, and all we did the manual dissection. So sometimes it is preferable to learn the manual, and if you see the visual outcome but and other factor, it is almost same. And going as per with any other international series, the complication, we have compiled our data and only less than 1% of the cases you need to change with a new cornea. Otherwise, you sometime the cornea may be little thicker, but you can easily go on the other side and you can make a thinner lenticule. But buttonholing again, you can change it. But very thin cornea, sometimes very difficult to handle. And but you can manage with different techniques. So endothelial cell loss are both are same, manual and automated, and we have compared our results. And if you go way back in 2007, this lady is doing very nice even after 11 years of surgery. So manual one is now we are coming back to manual. That I'm telling now that we are reinventing the wheel. Actually, nowadays, because of everything is DMEC is manual dissection, so we don't need to rethink about the huge investment of expensive microkeratome. Nowadays, the eye bankers actually keep the microkeratome, and the blades are costly. That way, DMEC is graft preparation is much cheaper than disec graft preparation. At any, you need just two punches and one Teflon block, and you just do the your dissection, and your graft is ready. And this graft, all Indian surgeon, we are making by ourselves, but in Western world, they get pre-prilled P-strip, P-stain, P-stem tissue, which are, one tissue is costing $5,000. So that is take-home message for the developing country like us. Unless the eye bank supplies pre-cut tissue to you, nowadays eye bank, many eye banks are supplying pre-cut tissue via CDS, central distribution system, then you have the pre-cut tissue. But don't invest on microkeratome, because DMEC will soon, you have to learn and you have to go with the DMEC. So we have two choices. And basic steps, there are certain differences. Rajesh again will be talking more on DMEC, I'll be talking more on DSEC. So basic steps, both the surgeries are very similar, but there are certain differences. So Rajesh will show you all the trips, but pre-op preparation both same. Initial surgical time, both the surgeries like 1 hour. Later on you can reduce both the surgeries by 20 minutes to 30 minutes. And you should keep all standby optical quality tissue for first 10-15 cases. Then always you remove the epithelium, your visibility is much better. Then you just put a template mark. I always prefer, but it is 8 to 8.5, 8.5 for DMEC, 8 for DSEC. Then site port entry, you must always remember you should not encroach the your inner port of the site port blade should not cross the your template mark, otherwise you have a difficulty in ER or BSS exchange. And we just go superior in DMEC, but in DSEC you can give corneal incision, but you can always prefer to have sclerocorneal tunnel as we do 5.5 millimeter in SICS incision, similar. Then this is DSEC incision, as I telling that, that you have to choose a right area from where you sometimes you need to go in little, because you need to see the previous scar, because the incision is much larger in DSEC, so you have actually 5 to 5.5 millimeter, usually sutureless in most of the time. Sutures requires during tamponade if you see the air bubble is leaking. Then your this DM scoring, same, only the little diameter difference. Otherwise you can just remove under dilate when doing a triple. When the visibility is not good, you can use strephon blue. You can use air especially in SEIA or DOHAD, there is aphakic patient, we don't want to put any viscoelastic. Some people using AC maintainer during screening. But whenever you use, if you use the viscoelastic, you use Hillon, because you could remove it completely. Then this is one of the mandatory steps, but recent article has shown that PI may not be necessary. But again, the situation differs from country to iris thickness is also different. So basically we need to do one PI, inferior PI, so that there should not be any pupillary block. But remember that there is bleeding whenever you do PI, so immediate AR tamponade for 3-4 minutes to stop that bleeding. Otherwise that blood actually may kill the surgery, whole surgery. So you have to remove each bit of fibrin thread from the anterior chamber. In clear cases, Western world, again we do not see those clear cases, you can do inferior YAC PI 3-4 hours before the surgery or one day before the surgery. Then you have this donor insertion unfolding, and you see that TECO technique, there is a different talk on it. So you listen to them. I prefer this TECO technique and sometimes needle techniques with or without sheet glides. So you can use the whole thing, or you can fold the tissue and also. And after that you have to centering the, this part is easier in dissect, but DMEC it is difficult. This part is difficult, but you can always center going to the interface, like you are not touching the endothelium. From the side port you negotiate your 27 gauge cannula and center. Keep that air for 10 to 12 minutes, then you exchange with BSS air. Normally in DMEC we do not exchange BSS air, we just keep. In DSEC we give extra tamponade, but in DMEC we just give just firm filling of the anterior chamber, so that you could see after 1 hour to see the patient under slit lamp. In DMEC the step is the introduction through a smaller side ports like 3 millimeter or 2.8 millimeter IOL injector, and you tap and it opens within, nowadays within maybe 1 minute to 2 minutes, whole grafts are open. So you just unfold it, and this centering is little difficult in DMEC, but again this air bubble injection all are basically little delicate, and you have to just firm fill, you see that, not overfill, and check the your S mark and just cover it sutureless. So immediate post-op is very crucial. Keep the patient in recovery room, maintain supine position for 45 minutes to 1 hour, then examine on that slit lamp. In sitting person, see the AR level. In DMEC, if it is above the ear, inferior PI, that is fine. But if not, then you can burp little air from the side sword using a Sinskyuk 30 gauge needle or a Macpherson's Forstep. And in case of DSEC, you see the air bubble should be above the lower border of the pupil. That means you are sure that pupillary block will not happen. And in our setup, we used to keep the patients overnight, but in Western world, they send the patient home after 4 hours, then see the patient next day. So take-home message is, India, we need to do a lot of EKs in any form, DSEC, DSAK or DMEC, because the cataract surgery rate has increased from 3,500 to nowadays more than 5,000 per million per year. Last year we did 6.5 million cataract surgery. That means we are ourselves producing more than 13,000 new patients every year. Currently, probably we are discussing, probably we are doing 5-6,000 EK in the country. We need no number of Fuchs dystrophy is always there. We need more number of trained EK surgeon. YouTube videos are there, wet lab is there, and masters are there all around you and for training. At the same time, so we need more number of excellent corneas and to respect the pricing issue of this wonderful surgery. Thank you very much.